What is up, guys, and welcome to the Heroic General Nazgrim Raid Guide. As always, in this guide, we're just going to be covering the differences between Normal Mode and Heroic Mode. So if you want to see the Normal Mode abilities, go ahead and click on my Siege of Orgrimmar playlist over my channel, and go ahead and check it out. But let's get right into this one. This fight is extremely similar to Normal Mode, but with a couple things that you do need to watch out for. Besides everything hitting harder, there are a couple mechanics that really will kill you. Being when he does the heroic leap onto somebody and he leaves that trail all over the ground, that orange kind of smoke that you see, you need to move out of that. It will kill you, period, end of story. That's a big thing to watch out for. Anytime he does a war stomp, again, you need to make sure that your healers are ready for it, that you have cooldowns set up, whether it be pallies, warriors, druids, you know, whatever your healing cooldowns might be, any health cooldowns, any, you know, damage reduction cooldowns for your raid, anything that you can do, make sure that you have those ready to go and cycled for when the next war song is coming out. Mitigating as much of that damage as possible is what's really going to keep everybody alive. Again, as we know, most of these Siege of Orgrimmar fights are combo fights. So, the other thing that we need to understand is that there is a new add that spawns, okay? So besides having the Shaman as your number one priority, which it still is, banners, again, priority once they are down, healing tide totems that the Shaman drop need to be killed ASAP. And so besides the Shaman and the normal stuff, there's also a sniper that spawns. A sniper can spawn, and what you want to do is he will fixate on somebody, and then if you remember Stone Guards, that boss who shoots the arrow volley, same idea, except it hurts your raid a ton. And remember, it won't kill you the first time you get hit by it, but as you get hit by wave and wave and wave, with all the combo damage coming out, you need to get out of these, okay? The easiest way to deal with this is if you do get chosen by the sniper, go ahead and stand against a wall so that he's shooting into a wall and shooting you and nobody else, and just let the healers know that, hey, I'm fixated, so that they know to bomb you with heals. Make sure you have your personal cooldowns, your health stones, anything that you have ready to go for this phase. Again, after that, the Arc Weavers, they do need to be interrupted as their damage increases exponentially. The more casts they get off, so making sure the Arc Weavers are after snipers, and then assassins. Obviously for assassins range, make sure that you're kiting these. Especially in heroic mode, they do a ton of damage, and as we've talked before, it's combo damage that kills you. So make sure that you're slowly kiting these around the room. If you can do traps, slows, stuns, anything you can do to keep these assassins from getting to their target is key. Also remember, if you can drag them through melee, melee can help out, maybe throw a couple slams on them, get a good cleave going, and then get back on the boss. But other than that, guys, it's really the same fight. Again, obviously you cannot DPS in defensive stance, and when you pop your heroism is really kind of dependent on where you are phase-wise and when you think you can kill them. There's a little bit of a Titan Rage on this, so making sure that you're getting optimal DPS out is important. However, you do need to understand that the adds are way more important than the boss during this fight. However, the boss is the one that does need to die for the enraged timer to end. So make sure that you are getting as much DPS as you can, but while controlling your DPS and tunneling it into the targets that it needs to go into. Once you kind of get used to this fight and you get used to the adds coming out and really slamming into them and then into the boss, not DPSing in defensive, making sure that you're moving out of the way when he does his leap, making sure that you have your heals up for war songs. This fight's going to go down really quick for you. It's not a hard heroic fight at all. Hope you guys like this one, and as always, see you in the next one.